QLD is 2 times of QQQ, TQQQ is 3 times, as these two ETFs were created after 2006. I did a simulation of them back to the 2000.com bubble. If they can recover from the worst case, we may consider them as an acceptable investment. Assume the initial values of these ETFs were 10,000. At the lowest point in 2002, QQQ 1700, QLD 145, TQQQ just 6. QQQ lost 83%. QLD would have lost more than 98%. TQQQ more than 99.9%. From 10,000 to 6. Let's check 2009, the lowest point. QQQ 2200, QLD 170, TQQQ 4. During the period from 2002 to 2009, QQQ gained 30%, QLD would have gained 10%, TQQQ would have dropped 30%. Would people have been able to tolerate such huge loss? I think most people would have sold their positions long before. What would the values be in May 2021 for these three ETFs? QQQ, 31,000, which is 3 times of the top of dot-com bubble. QLD, 21,000, which is 2 times more. TQQQ, 2,800, which is less than 10% of QQQ. This chart is just the log scale. If you check a linear scale, you can see clearly TQQQ would be less than 10% of QQQ. This simulation is just to test the worst scenario. If we had invested long before the dot-com bubble, QLD and TQQQ would have performed better than QQQ. For QLD and TQQQ, one more thing we need to consider is the annual management fee, which is about 1%. Also, they have tracking error, meaning that they may not be able to track the index perfectly. It is very common for the leveraged ETFs to have tracking errors. If you like this video, remember to click the like button and subscribe.